what route they're wanting to take, but you know, the word says that the fervent, fiery prayer of a righteous man availeth.
That's right.
If I wasn't myself, again, I'll use myself as an example. If I wasn't doing what I should be doing, then I was just trying to pray for myself. It ain't going to reach no further than the ceiling because I'm not living that life. I'm not having that close relationship that I should be having. So I need someone, and I should be able to go to the pastor and say, "You know, Pastor, I know I've done this and I've done that, and I really need to repent myself. But while I'm in this stage, could you do me a favor and could you pray for me on my behalf for a situation? Because, you know, I need this to happen, but I know that I'm not going to get it done." So the priests were telling Uzziah this. They were saying, "You're not living the life that you should be living. This is a holy place.
Right.
We should be the ones to be able to come in here on your behalf."
That's right.
And like any person would do, he began to get upset. It says, "Then Uzziah was wroth and had a censer in his hand to burn incense. And while he was wroth with the priests," as Pastor mentioned earlier, touching up my anointing. Because look what happens to Uzziah right here. "And while he was wroth with the priests, the leprosy even rose up in his forehead before the priests and the house of the Lord."
Yes.
"From beside the incense altar. And Azariah the chief priest and all the priests looked upon him, and behold, he was leprous in his forehead, and they thrust him out from thence. Yet he himself hasted also to go out, because the Lord had smitten him. And Uzziah the king was a leper unto the day of his death." So right there you take this story of Uzziah, 16 years of age, he took the throne. Did things in the sight of God, prospered, built cities, had armies, had all this stuff till he was strong that his name was reaching around. He was getting kind of popular. Word of mouth was going around. Man, King Uzziah's building this and building that. He got so proud that his own heart failed him because he thought, "I'm doing it all. I don't need to consult God no more. I don't need to allow God to have control over these plans because I'm going to do it." And then, going into the temple, and himself, just to burn incense. It didn't say he was going in to worship. It didn't say he was going in to give God some praise. He was going in just to burn some incense. But the priest informed him of what kind of life he was living, that he wasn't to be in that place. Got upset. And wrath, as the word says, with the priests, and leprosy instantly came upon him. So after all this that he'd done, all these great things that he'd done, being a young man taking the throne, as the last couple of verses of that chapter are going to tell you, instead of being a great king at 16 years of age, building cities and all this, all they can say is Uzziah was a leper. Went from a king to a leper. All because he took God out of his own equation. Now with that being said, thankfully none of us here today are lepers. However, if you feel, in which this is anybody, myself included, would need a closer walk with God,
right,
that can happen.